just to know.
What's happening, people? Welcome to today's session. What is up? I hope that all of you guys are doing good. Start of the week, people. Monday it is, and we're going to be starting off with a very interesting topic today. First of all, let me tell you one thing. If you have understood the sign convention of mirrors, this, my friends, is going to be a cakewalk. That's all I have to say. That is all I have to say. So welcome to today's session. This is going to be session number 12 of Lights. We have done a lot of sessions before this. So make sure that you watch all of that so that you are able to understand and relate to everything that is related to science and especially light wala chapter. Trust me, guys, the videos have been made super duper simple. So if you just watch it once, trust me, it will become a lot more easier for you to when you're revising your topics, which I know that all of you guys are scared of. In 3 months time, your exams are starting. I am pretty sure that your parents and friends and everyone is putting a lot of pressure on you. But yes, guys, just make sure you stay calm and give your best. All right. My name is Arup and I'm a master teacher of science here with Antu. Welcome to today's session. So in today's session, we'll be talking about the sign convention of lenses. But before we get into that, guys, there's a quote. Yes. And the quote for today is this. Once you start replacing your negative thoughts with the positive ones, you will start getting positive results. You have no idea, people, the power of your mind. You have no idea what your mind can do. I always believe the saying that, you know, a person who believes that he can and a person who believes he can't, both are true. If you believe that you can score 90%, you can, you will do it. If you believe that you can't do 90%, you will not do it because you are already put a, you've already put a limitations on your head and you're going to work according to that. So whatever is your thoughts, whatever is your belief system, that is what is going to give you the results. So if you're someone who's positive in your thoughts, then you're going to get positive results. If you're someone who's thinking always, you know, what could possibly go wrong, because there are 101 ways of things, you know, for things to go wrong. If you're thinking like that, then obviously that is what you're gonna get as well. So positive thoughts, make sure you start from now on, people. And how do you do it? There are a lot of ways to do that. Make sure that you always stay in a good company with people who are always trying to push you up, not who's gonna pull you down. Right, that's the first step. In the sessions ahead, I'll give you one, you know, such small tips to prepare yourself mentally so you can go give your board exams in this rocket, all right? So anyways, guys, today we'll be talking about the sign convention of lenses. It's a very small topic, so just give me the next 10 to 15 minutes of your time and we'll be done, guys. I don't think I'll need 15 minutes also. It's a very small topic. Let's quickly get into it, and then we will also do some quiz questions as well. I hope you guys are excited for that. Anyways, so in the last session, guys, I'd given you homework. The question was this: as the object moves away from a concave lens, what happens to the size of the image? As you take the object away, further and further away from the lens, the object, the image size is also going to get smaller and smaller. So it decreases. As you bring the object closer to the lens, on the other hand, the image is going to get bigger and bigger. So the answer is going to decrease. That's it, people. Very, very simple question. I hope that you guys were able to give the right answer. Hats off to all of those guys who were able to give the right answer. Congratulations. Well done. So that's it, guys. Let's get into today's topic. Before I get into the lenses part, let me talk a little bit about mirrors. So if you guys remember, we had done the ray diagrams, and we also did a couple of problems on how to use the mirror formula and magnification to find out what are the different properties of images. Now, one thing I would like to reiterate is this, guys. A ray diagram tells you approximately where the image is found, but the mirror formula or the lens formula tells you exactly where the image is going to be formed, or exactly where the object is placed, or exactly where the focal length is. So it's all about finding the exact image or the exact object or the exact focal length. So that is what your mirror formula tells you. So using a mirror formula, you can tell out or pinpoint where exactly that is. Now, in mirrors, we have seen that the sign convention goes something like this. Anything that is above the top, like if you remember your Cartesian coordinates of your, you know, your, if you've seen a simple graph, you know that the Cartesian coordinates are like this, that anything above on your, this is the y-axis, this is your x-axis. Anything on the top is considered as positive. Anything on the bottom of the y-axis is taken as negative. Anything on the left-hand side is taken as negative. And anything on the right-hand side is taken as positive. And it's the exact same thing over here as well. So anything in front of the mirror is taken as negative. Anything behind the mirror is taken as positive. And above the mirror is taken as positive, and below the mirror is taken as negative. Now this, I'm talking about a concave mirror. In a convex mirror, it'll be a little different, but nonetheless, it is going to be the same. Over there also, the mirror would basically look like this. And here also, you see this, this side is going to be negative, behind the mirror is going to be positive, above is positive, and below is negative. And this is the exact same thing in lenses also. So if you remember, if you just remember the sign conventions of mirrors, you don't even have to look at the sign convention of lenses because it's exactly the same. So let me just quickly take you through it. So for lenses also, we have sign convention. That's obvious, no? We are here for that. What is the statement? But yes. Now, what is the sign convention of lenses? Once again, first of all, guys, all the distances are measured from the optical center or the geometric center of the lens. All the distance is measured from this point. From this point is where all the distance is measured. And generally, the object is kept on the left-hand side, all right? So the incident light, so the object is kept on the left-hand side. This is the object. So incident light is coming and incidenting on the, or the light, ray of light is coming and incidenting on the lens. And so anything to, with, along with it, anything along with that incident light is taken as positive. That means anything to the right-hand side is taken as positive because the ray of light is coming from left to right. So anything towards or along with the incident ray is taken as positive. Anything that is opposite to the incident ray is taken as negative. That means on the left hand side, you have negative, or everything is taken as negative. On the right hand side, you've taken everything to be positive. And once again, anything above the principal axis is taken as positive, and anything below the principal axis is taken as negative. That's all, guys. That is all about sign convention. We've done it in what, 2 minutes, I believe? That's it, guys. It's all about remembering one thing. See, the thing about light is that if you know the first half of the chapter by heart, if you're not by heart per se, but if you know everything about that, the second half of the chapter is like laddu, people. So remember that. Anyways, now to bring it all into picture, first thing, all distance are measured from the optical center O, and distance along the incident light, that is towards the right hand side, is taken as positive. Anything in the opposite direction to the incident light, or in the left hand side, is taken as negative. Above the principal axis positive, below the principal axis negative. All right, now that you've understood this, let's talk a little bit more about how do you use this in your problems. So guys, generally the object is kept on the left hand side. So your object distance is always going to be negative, and it is represented by the letter U. So U is the small u, represents the object distance, and is generally kept on the left hand side, and hence the object distance always taken as negative. But the image distance, on the other hand, would vary, because obviously for some mirrors it can be on the same side, for some lenses on the same side as the object, for some it can be on the other side of the lens as well. So let's talk about the focus of a concave as well as convex lens before we understand about the image formation. Now, talking about the focus, guys, if we talk about a convex lens, the focus is going to be positive. You know why? Because the focus of a convex lens always lies on the right hand side. Because it's a converging mirror, rays of light are actually meeting on the other side, and hence it's always taken as positive. Whereas if we talk about a concave lens, it's going to be negative. Why? Because the focus of a concave lens lies on the same side as that of the object, because it's a diverging lens, right? So all the rays of light are diverging away from each other, and they appear to meet at a point on the same side as that of the object, and hence it's going to be negative. Whereas convex lens is going to be positive, concave lens on the other hand is going to be negative. That's it, right? Simple? Yes. Now, to sum it all up, again, the object distance is taken as negative, the focal length of the convex lens is taken as positive, the focal length of concave lens is taken as negative. Simple. That's it. Simple. Now, to sum it all up, guys, now this is where I want everyone to quickly take a screenshot. This is the entire thing in just one glance. Trust me, guys, if you just understand this one image, no? This chapter is done, people. I mean, a little bit more, but yeah, pretty much done. 99% of the chapter is done. Now, for a convex lens, the object distance for both concave and convex is negative because the object is always kept on the left-hand side. When you talk about the image, which is represented as U, if it's a real image, when you talk about a convex lens, it's going to be paused because the real images would be on the other side of the lens. And if it's a virtual image, if it's a virtual lens, it's going to be on the same side, and hence it's going to be negative. That, remember the last case, the sixth ray diagram that we see, on that we saw the object is, or the image is formed on the same side as that of the object, so it's going to be negative over there. Now, the focal length on the other hand is positive, and there's no virtual focus, so you don't have to worry about that being negative at all. For a convex lens, it's always going to be positive all the time. Height of the object is always going to be positive. Height of the object is going to be positive. And height of the image on the other hand, if it's real, you know that it's going to be inverted. That means it's going to be like this. So that means that the image is going to be other. It's going to be negative. And if it's virtual, it's going to be positive. Because you know that in a convex lens, you get both virtual and real images. So that's what it would look like. In a concave lens, on the other hand, it's going to be negative. Object distance is going to be negative. There is no real image found, so you don't have to worry about that. But all the images are virtual, so it's going to be negative. And apart from that, there is no real focus because everything virtual, the focus is virtual, so it's going to be negative on the same side as that of the object, so it's going to be somewhere over there. And apart from that, if you talk about the height of the image, again, there is no real images formed, it's not going to be positive. It's always it's not going to be negative. It's always going to be positive. Why? Because virtual images are always erect, and because of that, it's going to be positive because anything above the principal axis is taken as positive. And finally, guys, the height of the object is always taken as positive, so that remains the same. Now, what I want you guys to do is to take a screenshot of this and keep it with you, because in your final exams, guys, if you want to refer to any of this, it's going to be super damn easy. So make sure that you take a screenshot of this. You can pause the video and do it. With that said, people, that is pretty much it for what I had to teach, but we're not done yet because I have a very super awesome surprise for you guys. I know that majority of you already know about, but still, for all the new guys out there who are still watching the videos for the very first time, first of all, welcome to Vedantu. And this here is going to be something that is going to help you guys out in your studies as well. So we had put up a poll asking you people, what are the problems that you people are facing? Now, I'm pretty sure that as soon as you hear the word problem, there'll be like 100,000 problems that'll come into your mind. But let me just tell you some of the problems that you guys are facing, especially when it comes to studies. Firstly, doubts, right? Getting your doubts cleared, getting cleared has become a very big problem now. Secondly, notes, because you can't always download the notes or watch the recordings of every session. You know, it's become a big deal to do that. Thirdly, tests and assignments, because you don't want to go and sit in your board exams without any sort of practice. So getting the tests and assignments done is very, very important. Fourthly, competitive exams, because you don't want to, because your NTSC is right around the corner and you don't want to just go and sit in front of the exam hall again. You want to practice. So how do you get those questions to, you know, make yourself better? Fifth, choice of your own schedule. That also has become a very big deal, right? Because some days you don't feel like starting at 5 o'clock, so you're like, you know, you don't want to attend the sessions. So that's that has become a very big problem. You don't feel like studying when the teacher's teaching, when you want to study, the teacher is not teaching. So there's this big conflict of interest as well happening. And finally, guys, choice of your own language, right? Because not every one of us are comfortable in English, not every one of us are comfortable in Hindi. So how do you solve these many problems? There's one solution, people, one stop solution, and that there is nothing but Vedantu, guys. We have solved all of your problems. How do we do so? Inside the class, people, you will not just have the master teacher. No. You also have the class teacher to help you clear your doubts as well. The class teacher's job is to make sure that your doubts are cleared inside the class itself. You can download all the notes and watch every recordings of every class, so you don't miss out on anything that is important. Thirdly, you get regular tests and assignments, and based on these tests and assignments, you also get a detailed report card as well. You'll be trained for your competitive exams. You can choose your own schedule, whatever time you feel like studying, you can choose that time. You don't have to come to the teacher's will. You don't have to go according to the company's will. You can go according to your will. And finally, guys, you can choose your own language. If you're someone who's comfortable in English, you can go with that. If you're someone who's comfortable in Hindi, then you can go with that as well. And apart from these, guys, it's not done. You have unlimited live classes, all micro courses and crash courses, detailed performance report card based on the tests and assignments that you take, which tells you what topics you're good at, what topics you're bad at, every single detail, and also personalized attention with the help of the class teacher. All of it at one place, guys. Trust me, this is like Baskin Robbins of education. You have so many choices and you can choose whatever you want. Now, all you have to do is click on the link that is given in the description below, people. So once you click on the link, this is what you're going to get. They'll ask you which grade do you belong to. So choose whichever grade you're in. Let's say you're in 10th grade, they'll ask you. The next step is they'll ask you which board do you belong to, CBSE, ICSE or Maharashtra. Let's say you're in CBSE or ICSE, you just click on that and what happens, this is what you're going to get. Every single detail that I just told you, all of it in one shot. What you have to do is click on get subscription. Once you click on get subscription, this is what you're going to get. 1 month, 3 month or the 6 month program. Let's say you want to go for the 1 month program and see how it works out and decide whether you want to do it further or not. So the base price of this 1 month program is 4,000 rupees, which we know that is a lot of money. So we have cut down the price to 2,699. On top of this, if you want to save more money, enter the coupon code AMEPRO, get additional 540 rupees discount, and what you'll be paying essentially for the whole month is 2,159 rupees. Now, I know that it seems like a lot of money, but think about it, guys. You're going to be studying with the best of the best teachers, with the best of the best online platform, with quizzes every single day, and tons of activities we'll be doing in the class as well. So trust me, guys, this is one of the best decisions that you're going to take, because 2,000 rupees though, if you go to a showroom to buy a dress, that's it, the 2,000 rupees is gone. This is something that you'll be investing for your own future. Let's go over the 3 month program. The 3 month program is what I would suggest you to go with, because your exams are coming up in March, Feb. So it's important that you go for the 3 month program. Don't go for the 6 month one because it's too long. Let's go for the 3 month program. If you want to go for the 3 month program, the base price of that is 10,000 rupees. Again, to make it more affordable, we've cut down the price to 6,999. On top of that, if you enter the coupon code AMEPRO, you get additional 1,400 rupees discount. And what you'll be paying for the next 3 months is 5,599 rupees for the next 3 months. All of it, once again, guys, again, I can't stress enough, the best of the best teachers with the best online platform. 6 month program is about 16,000 rupees. Again, it's cut down to 11,499. On top of that, if you enter the coupon code AMEPRO, you get additional 2,300 rupees discount. And what you'll be paying for the next 6 months is 9,199 rupees. So that's it, guys. Once again, the link is given in the description below. And do not forget the coupon code AMEPRO to avail that extra discount so that it gets a little bit more affordable for all of you guys out there. So that's it, people. Now, with that said, let's get into the questions. Now, I know you've been waiting for this for a long time. Now, let's solve these questions. Now, again, what I expect you guys to do is solve the questions with me. I don't want you to sit and do nothing. Solve it with me, either in your mind or write in a notebook or put it out in the comment section below. Whatever works fine for you guys. Make sure that you do that, because I want to see how it's like. And do not forget to like, share and subscribe, people. Show us some love, show me some love, so that I know that okay, you guys aren't finding it helpful. So let me know in the comment section below how are the sessions, and also do not forget to like, share and subscribe to the channel as well. So here's the question, guys. What will be the sine of the focal length of a concave lens? If you talk about a concave lens, what is the focal length going to be? Is it positive, negative, concave or zero? The answer, concave. Negative, people. It's going to be negative for a concave lens. It's always going to be negative. So that is the answer. Second question. What is the sine of the object distance u? So it's a convex lens. You're supposed to find out what is the object distance. It's kept on the left hand side. Negative again, people. Negative. Because why? It's on the left hand side. Simple. Third question. What should be the sine of the object height ho? Or H is nothing but the height of the object. So anything above the principal axis taken as positive, anything below the principal axis is negative. So if this is the object, what is going to be the sign on it? Positive. Simple question. Laddu questions. Bacha questions, people. Here is your homework as well. Let me know what is your homework in the comment section below, so that the next session that I come live, I can take a screenshot of that and put your names in the start of the session as well. So the question is, distance below the principal axis is what? Such a simple question. If I was asked this question, I would have answered it that. Come on. Distance below the principal axis, what? Let me know what is the answer in the comment section below, guys. So that's it from my side. Once again, if you want to join for the NTSC course as well, here is the link, people. So it's vdnt.in/vus. That is a YouTube link. You can join, take part in that as well. You'll have six best teachers you'll be trained and you know, you'll be in safe hands when it comes to your NTC preparation as well. And if you want to join the long-term courses on that, or the core courses on the NTC, this is the package. So if you go for the NTC prep, 2020 prep, that is basically 999 rupees. You get a 90% discount on that, and it'll come down to 999 for your NTC. The entire preparation with mock test and preparation would just cost you 999 rupees. And this is the link to join it. And if you talk about the NTC mock test paper, that'll be just 99 rupees. Again, you get a 90% discount. So if you are sure that you can prepare it by yourself, and you could just, you just need the question paper, just join for that as well. So that is the link. You can take you know, take a peek at that as well, please. So all the best for your NTSCs, and all the best for your future as well. Once again, do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. Spread the word, people. Spread the love. And also let me know in the comment section below, how are you enjoying these sessions? And also do not forget to like. Make me feel good, people. Make us feel good. We are dependent on our audio likes. We are like vampires. Yeah, but vampires for not for blood, but for likes. So yeah, all of us. So yeah, let us know in the comment section below. Thank you for joining once again. I hope to see you guys soon in the live sessions. Thank you for joining. See you in the next one. Take care of yourself. Stay safe. And this is Anup signing off for the day.